You're listening to the SWN podcast.
And this is SWN.
Welcome to SWN.
Skull! Skull! Skull!
This is SWN.
And this is the Scottish Wrestling Network.
Where Scottish wrestling lives, I guess. Is that a tagline? I guess. I don't know.
Hello and welcome to the latest edition of the SWN podcast. I am your host as always, Billy, and we're back on the road. I can't remember how many road trips we've done this particular season. Season 7 must be two. I can't remember now, because I think we did quite a few on the back end of season 6, the on tour season. So here we are. We're off to Peterhead for an afternoon or an evening of wrestling from Community Pro Wrestling. Live at Peterhead Football Club. So we'll be going there. We'll be going to we'll watch some wrestling. It's as simple as that. So usually I like to do the little preamble bit on this about the card. If you can actually see me. Hang on. Hello again. Which has been dicey because, oh, the recording's dicey because I'm trying to balance my phone here. I still haven't. I got loads of like little new tech things, like microphones and stuff like that. Didn't get a phone stand. Didn't get a phone stand for it. So I'm still using the little tripod that I've got. I've jammed it into a chair, into the chassis side chair, and hoping for the best. That's just how we're still doing it. Anyway, yeah, I like to do a preamble and talk about just updates on the podcast itself. We've been really busy. July time, the first week of July is usually my birthday. We try to do something for it, and then like the third weekend is my son's birthday, so we do something for that as well. So that kind of blocks out half of July when it comes to doing recordings and things like that. So despite of that, I've packed the end of June into July with loads of chats, and we're hopefully going back to one a week back into August, but probably not going to be that. It's still going to be like two or three episodes per week, whether it's three interviews or if it's two interviews and a preview show. We still have plenty of regular programming on the Scottish Wrestling Network, which is fun. It's a lot of fun to do. It's a little bit stressful, I'm not going to lie to you. But it's fun, that's the most important thing, because I enjoy doing the podcast stuff, because no one else is. There is like little podcasts popping up that deal with Scottish wrestling, but nobody's really doing a dedicated regular podcast on Scottish wrestling, and we're still filling that void, so to speak. So got that. We're still inquiring. I'm sending emails near daily to try and get new guests on, new guests on, not just returning guests, which have been great to have back on, because I've been getting like first, second season guests back on, and I think I've grown as an interviewer since those podcasts. I definitely have, because the last couple I've done, I felt really, really like, I don't want to say like professional, but I feel like I'm proud of my work kind of thing. And I very rarely think that, because I'm a very pessimistic person about my own accomplishments. But it's been feeling good. So I'm hoping to get a few more season one or two guests back on for season 7. But we've got plenty still lined up. I think by the time this episode comes out, hopefully, we'll have chatted to Tim Strange, a guest who I've wanted on for a little while. And it's just more a case of lining up the dates to accommodate both of us. So hopefully that has happened. But it's a lot of contacting, a lot of emailing, a lot of ghosting. But, you know, people are busy. You know, I don't expect anyone to give up their time for me. Especially for free. Because I have contacted some bigger guests, and then They've come back with a fee, and that's absolutely their prerogative. I'm not going to... it's their time. If they want to ask for a fee, they ask for a fee. It's just we don't make a lot of money here at SWN. All the money that really goes into the Patreon goes back on to Zoom, paying for my Zoom sub, or paying for a little bit of tech or upgrades or whatever that I want to add on to the quality of the podcast. Even though I'm still editing the exact same way, aka barely, we do have an upgraded, some upgraded like laptop. We've upgraded with little bits and pieces along the way. So if wrestlers ask for a fee, again, do not hold it against them. That is their prerogative. It's just something we can unfortunately provide at this moment in time. I'm running this podcast near 300 episodes, 100% on goodwill, on the time the wrestlers are giving us to speak and to have a chat for an hour. And yeah, like I said, I'm really proud of my work recently. I think I'm asking the right questions, or at the very least, I'm not asking the wrong questions. I'm remembering things, I've got notes, guests I've had on. Generally, it's amazing to see like returning guests, like guests I had on first those first two seasons, when it was quite a negative experience for at the time, because so much was happening in wrestling, in British wrestling, and in the world, in the pandemic as well. It was very easy to get into a negative headspace a lot of the time, and talking about all the trials and tribulations of things that were going on. And now I'm getting them back on in those last 2 years that this happened, has taken place, and seeing the difference and the positivity that's come out of it, you know? So that's been really fun. Specifically, speaking to Shamanee, I mean, there were some things we couldn't speak about, and he understood that, absolutely understood that I wouldn't speak about certain things, certain promotions, and we agreed, we moved on. And we had a great chat, and like I said, it was a very positive experience, because last time, yeah, it was very negative, it was just a harsh time. That was episode 99, that was the episode with Shay originally. And the episode that I've recorded with them, I think it's 286 or something like that, 288, maybe 289, you know, I'll hedge my bets here. So, 200 episodes later, and getting that new experience, that new outlook, especially with him promoting a promotion, a show himself, with them coming out, which will have passed by now, time this episode goes out, I think. Must have, yeah, because it's the 19th of July, and I'm recording this. This will go out on the 22nd, I think. It's great to see the change in wrestlers and people during those periods, during those two 3 years between chats. Because I've been doing this podcast now for 4 years, you know? And it was all spawned out of, I'm stuck in the house, I generally don't need human interaction, but I've got no wrestling to go to, I've got no no wrestling to watch. I've got the four walls, and it was me, my wife, and the dog. And generally, that's all the company I need. Now Jack as well, but it's all the company I need. But something about the pandemic and how being told you couldn't go out just made me crave some human interaction. And that I've spent 10 years now doing this website, the SWN website, swnscotland.com, and it's daily. I've been putting stuff out daily. I've been doing results. I've been doing news. I've been doing articles, you know? And because nothing was going on, I had nothing to do. I had nothing to write about, nothing to try and preview or anything like that. So I needed something. I needed some sort of wrestling outlet in my life. And the podcast was the way to do that. So we started with the 21st of June, 2020. It was a very awkward time in pro wrestling in general, but I had Omar Muhammad on, pre-TV Omar Muhammad as well. We had a great chat, and that's kind of where it went from there. I mean, it started off, it was going to be half an hour episodes, and that would be it. We'd talk about wrestling, maybe talk about, just kind of try and keep it condensed as possible, and then it turned into maybe two, near 3 hour episodes at times, depending on which guest I've got on the podcast at the time. So it's really went from one thing, like kind of, like not serious, I suppose, but like serious questions, straight-laced questions to asking silly questions and finding out things that I didn't know about. A lot of the early ones is me finding out about anime and D&D, which I still know nothing about, but I appreciate people who are taking the time to talk to me about it. You know, that's the most important thing. So we've had quite the journey in SWN and in Scottish Wrestling Network, considering that started... I mean, the name change happened... I can't remember the name change happened. I think it was just before the pandemic, or maybe the year before that. But we're still operating under OSW-TV. I can't remember. It's a bit of a blur. I'm sure the pandemic started, it was like March, and then I did the name change in April. But I'd be absolutely lying if to be perfectly frank with you, to remember. So Scottish Wrestling Network stuff's going on. It's been a hell of a journey, considering, like, right, so it's not, obviously it's not, I've seen discourse on Twitter or X about, like, oh, how like this Hoktua girl has got all these offers and that, because she's famous in the moment and people have capitalised on it, and fair play to her. She's taking it and running with it, and absolutely fair to her. And then there's people going, oh, I've been working on this for years and all that kind of thing. And I think if you enjoy it, the years kind of go by quickly, you know. I've been doing the website for 10, doing the podcast for 4, and I still enjoy it. I still enjoy what I'm doing. I might not be getting a million hits. I'm barely hitting 100 at times on YouTube. Audio, I'm hitting about 200, maybe 250 listens per episode-ish. And I still enjoy it. You know, I still enjoy doing what I'm doing, and it's afforded me opportunities, and I've gotten brave through it as well. I don't think I would have gotten Scotty Hottie on the podcast. I wouldn't have gotten a lot of wrestlers, a lot of guys I'm intimidated by that I've been able to get on the podcast. But I've been able to do that because the podcast is something that I enjoy, and it's very easy. You know, I'm not going to be asking questions about controversial subjects generally. I don't think I have as yet, or anything I have asked about is controversial. We've been able to kind of navigate through it, and it's just fun. Do I have a bucket list of people I want to get on that may be Scottish related, non-Scottish related? Absolutely. Have I contacted them? Yes, I have. Have they replied? No. Actually, that's a lie. One has, and it was Mr. Anderson, or Mr. Kennedy. We had a little bit of a back and forth. It just hasn't come to anything. Same with Jeff Jarrett as well. We was pre-AEW Jeff Jarrett. Had a chat, we had some back and forth, and it looked promising, and then he got signed by AEW, and then it kind of just fizzled out from there. So it's not like if people are going, so very regularly I see people putting out a post going, who would you like to see on the podcast? And that's just so I can get kind of gauge who people want. And almost 9 out of 10 times I will have already contacted, or I've probably contacted them, or I've had them on before fairly recently. You know, it's all good getting guests back on, but I think we need a good gap or a subject if I'm going to get them on quickly. You know, like Martin McAllister being a great example. I had him on at the end of last year, 2023. And then there's a wind turbine going past, for those that wonder why I've stopped. End of 2023, and then I think he's the quickest that's come back on for an episode, because he won the the Ann Gerders Pro Wrestling Championship. So that was a big story to talk about. So we got back on for what was supposed to be like 20 minutes, took 45, and both of our tech and internet died in that space of time, which is always going to make me a fan of Martin McAllister, because he was so nice about it. He was so positive. He is the power of positivity. He is the charge. I can't remember what his handle is for that. The page of positivity. That's not right. But yeah, he's always going to be a kind of soft spot for Martin because of that. I have no idea where I was going with this conversation. I've forgotten. Oh yeah, getting guests back on. Yeah, so I appreciate people going, oh, get this person back on. But if I've had them on very recently, like in the last 6 months or so, There's not, there'll be some things to speak about, but there won't be a lot to speak about in a 6 month period, unless there's a specific subject that we want to talk about. Like, I'd have Ian Skinner on the podcast once a month, easily. Because we would pick a movie, we'd watch it, we'd talk about it, and that's an hour, easily. You know, so it'd be at least wrestling, it wouldn't be wrestling related content, to be perfectly honest with you, but I'd have Ian Skinner on the podcast anytime. Once we figure out, like, kind of a reason for it, like, are we going to watch The Batman? Probably not. But if we're going to watch a film, we'll watch it and then come back, because I really enjoyed the Starship Troopers chat. It was probably one of my favourites of the season so far, because we just had a really good in-depth chat, and I brought some new points that he hadn't heard before, even though he's seen the film hundreds of times. So it's those sort of things that are intriguing, and when I'm bringing back a guest on, if they've got a topic that they want to speak about, I'm generally all game to go on. Same with the show previews. I'll probably have guests on sooner, because we can just do a little bit of what we've been up to in the last 6 months. But we're talking about the show, we're doing a preview, which is what I should be doing now. I should be doing a preview for Community Pro Wrestling Live in Peterhead, which is taking place at Peterhead Football Stadium. But I haven't done that yet, and I will. I think there's 7 matches on the card. I'm trying to remember them all offhand, so I apologise if I do forget. I'll probably do a second bit when I get to Peterhead and really kind of correct myself, I'll never remember which ones I actually remembered on this preview portion of the podcast, but in any event. Right, well, let's talk about the show then. So Peterhead, this will be my third trip to Peterhead in the last 12 months, I think, possibly. So the Community Pro Wrestling, last time came to Peterhead Football Club. We got a bunch of cool chats on that one. I don't know if I'll get the same tonight. I'll try. They're very accommodating, our the talent at CPW, so I might get a chat or two in there. That was Peterhead Football Club. That was a fun show. It was a chaotic show. I was going to see Leighton Buzzard in one of his final matches before he went off to Japan. It was just a really fun night of wrestling. And then I was back in February. Yes, I'll say February. For WrestleZone, they did a show at the Station Hotel in Peterhead. Station Hotel? Blue Tune Wrestling Extravaganza, what it was called anyway. I think it was Station Hotel. Victoria Hotel. It's not really important to this portion of the chatty bit. So we went to that and had a good time, a really good time at that one. And here we are. We're into July, and I'm now another year older, not so much wiser, but we're here to talk about Community Pro Wrestling. So they've been putting on, like, just shows, constant shows. Like, every 2 weeks there seems to be a Community Pro Wrestling show, and they're very quick at announcing matches and all that kind of stuff in quick succession. So my eyes are all over the place trying to figure out, is this for a Helensburgh show? Is this for a Greenock show? Is this for a Govan show? Just trying to get my bearings on there. So I've got 7 matches announced for this one, and I'm going to try and remember all of them. So a lot of guys I haven't seen before live. I think I've seen maybe bits and pieces of at least like Thorin and stuff like that, who I'll speak about in a sec. So a lot of kind of newish faces, some returning faces as I've seen before, and a fun night. So the pre-show match is a Big Strong Challenge, I think. I don't know if it's advertised as a Big Strong Challenge, but I certainly know it's the Big Strong Man taking on Brian Mojo. Brian Mojo, who went a little bit viral thanks to a balcony moonsault that he did, which looked mad. So we've got that to look forward to. I've got a general admission ticket, so I probably won't see that particular match. I may see the tail end of it, but I do quite like the big strong man, his persona. So we'll see how that kind of goes. I'd like to see Brian Mojo in action as well, so we'll see how that fares. Maybe I could sneak in, or maybe I'll catch the tail end of it like I did last year. On to the main card. What have we got? We've got Big Ross Hauser taking on Mayhem Brooks. So that's Mayhem Brooks from Elgin, of course. Mayhem, well, I'll see you again at the end of the month at W3L in Elgin. So that should be a bit hard hitting. We've got Big Ross, who just likes leathering folk and throwing them around, and we've got Mayhem, who likes to kick and throw some submissions in. So a nice little combo of stuff and things for that one. We've also got a triple threat. It was supposed to be a women's championship match, a CPW women's championship match, but that's not going to happen now because Debbie Keitel is the new CPW women's champion. It's a triple threat. It's Nicole Jasmine taking on Cassie Cook and Ellie Armstrong, and which I adore Ellie. I think Ellie Armstrong is great, so I'm looking forward to seeing what she brings to it. Nicole I've seen several times as well. Cassie I've never seen wrestle. I've heard good things as well, so that should be a nice tight little triple threat on the show. Oh god, now here I go. Six man tag. We've got Xander, my cousin Xander, and the Vicious Lads, E Town and Rocky Ross, taking on Thatcher's Cabinet, which is Thatcher Wright, King Nicholas Justice, and Ryan Richards. I think it's unofficially in Thatcher's Cabinet. I don't think Ryan Richards is officially in the cabinet. So we're going to see, Ryan again. Ryan, who we last saw at Discovery. So Discovery and that triple threat against Leon Slayer and Gene Money. So we'll get to see him. That'll just be some chaos, really. Probably just be a bit of chaos. It might end up just being like last time. It'll end up being announced as a Glasgow Street Fight or a Peterhead Street Fight, and they'll just then batter each other around the hall, which is more than likely going to happen. But it'll be fun. It'll be a good kickle anyway. What else we've got? So we've got Ravy Davey taking on Thorin from the pack. So Thorin had put out a promo and he's not kind of saying that he's not going to be the pack's Thorin. He's going to be showing a new side of him. He had kind of like the Viking garb. He had the big horn drinking chalice kind of thing. So it's going to be a little bit more different than maybe you'd expect to go into it. When you see Thorin announced, you think it'd be the pack, a bit more brooding and that. Might get to see a bit more of a chaotic side to Thorin in this match itself. What else we've got the Hardcore Championship is on the line. I think he's still Hardcore Champion. The Wanderer, I'm sure he is. The CPW JB Dub Hardcore Champion. Yeah, positive he is. The Wanderer will defend against Manky Frankie Richards. I don't know how that's going to go. Again, it's all matches that could just end up being a chaotic street fight. And someone trying to find an excuse to be thrown through the back door into the football stadium. So we'll just see how that correlates for it. We've got the CPW Heavyweight Championship online. Not Joe Hendry. Joe Hendry is not the CPW Heavyweight Champion. The title was put back to SBX, Sam Barber Experience. And he'll be taking on Darrow for that title. I think that's it. I think that's all the matches announced. Hang on, I do have it written down because I knew I'd forget. Because they were announced quite a while ago. I got the ball. Hey, check me. I am a professional. So yeah, seven matches have been announced. Last time there was a couple of changes on the night. So we'll see if that's the case again. But it should be some fun. You know, it's definitely going to be a fun show. Whether it's going to be like storyline advancing or any of that kind of stuff, that remains to be seen. But I think as a show itself and as a spectacle and just enjoying some wrestling for a couple hours, it's certainly going to tick all those boxes for me anyway. Will it be perfect? Probably not. But am I going to enjoy myself? Absolutely. Is my face going to look like it does? No, probably not. I like doing that, asking questions and answering them clearly. I do that quite a lot. So yeah, I don't have issues with trying to have phone storage. I got a new phone like a couple of weeks ago, so it's got loads of storage, so I'll be able to hopefully record some bits and just have some content for you guys and like make this an hour long podcast of me rambling like an idiot, and maybe get a montage in. I've done a montage in ages. Is it Happy Anarchy? I didn't even do a montage for Happy Anarchy, so it must have been Rumble, is it, the last time? Oh, Discovery. I think it was Discovery the last time I did a montage. So it'd be nice to actually get a montage going again and have some fun that way. But I think, Can I think of anything else just now? Nah, I can't. I've been rambling on for about 25 minutes now, so I think that's possibly enough for this first half of the show, because I'll have plenty to talk about on the back half of the show when I'm getting lost on the way out of Peterhead. Last time I did it for WrestleZone, I came out of Peterhead and ended up in Fraserburgh, which is pretty much adjacent to Peterhead. So I went no further. I just went across and not down, or wherever I needed to, like, wherever direction I needed to be to get home. So hopefully it goes better than that. That's the hope and prayer. I'll be driving past Newport Sligo, so that'll be fun for me as someone who lived there for a couple of years. But other than that, hopefully the next thing you'll see will be me in Peterhead, or it'll be me, it'll be the ring, and then it'll be hopefully a montage. If not, and I've absolutely colossally cocked everything up, and the next thing you'll see will be me driving home. So it remains to be seen what we're going to see. But in the meantime, behave yourselves. I'll see you in the next half. And I don't know, drink your water. I don't know, I'm not very good at this bit. We're just about to hit Keith. So the town, not the person. Maybe. I don't know. My driving leaves much to be desired. Anyway, have a good one.
2 hours later.
So that's me and Peterhead. I've been here for like an hour or so. I have had the journey from bloody hell. So usually, like, if I'm going to Peterhead, I take the coastal route, so I go from Elgin, past Bucky, Cullen, all that kind of stuff. However, on this occasion, for some reason, I stopped in Keith, and I don't know the journey off the top of my head to get to Peterhead from there, so I had to look for a turn off to Banff to get on the road anew. So that was a 20-mile detour. So a 20-mile detour, and then for the last 30 miles between Banff and Peterhead, I needed to pee so badly. So I finally got to and also the little bar came up on my petrol gauge. So it's been an absolute arse of a trip, to be honest. But it's not gonna let me. It's not gonna make me spoil. It's not gonna spoil my enjoyment of wrestling tonight. When I got food, I was planning to keep this second monster of the day for the journey home. But I need it now because I am shattered and I need to drive home later. So usually it would be then like montage bit. So it's coming up next. Montage time, hopefully. I've done a montage in a little bit, in a minute. And I'll see what else I can get. If not, it's just 20 minutes of me speaking on the way home. And then it's possibly 10, 15 minutes of me speaking at home in the studio. I'm going to record that bit on Saturday, or tomorrow, I think, probably, because I've got the hoose to myself, so probably do that. Anyway, right, let's go watch some wrestling.
Thank you.
Hello, party people. This is the post show. I got a lot of video for the montage, so hopefully that has come across. I'm going to try something for the montage. I'm going to use iMovie to try and put it together, just to see what happens, really. But in the meantime, that was Community Pro Wrestling in Peterhead, and it was wild. It was chaotic. I'm not entirely sure if Community Pro Wrestling will be back in Peterhead. Certainly, maybe not on the Peterhead Football Club anytime soon, because the main event ended up with them fighting on the actual pitch itself. So I'm fairly aware that's quite frowned upon when it comes to the old football clubs wrestling on the pitch. So we'll see. We'll see how that how it affects things, and if we'll see if Ruby Davey and that will be back in Peterhead in the near future. The show itself, it was a pretty good show. It was a pretty good show. The crowd wasn't as like rough as last time. It was like quite a feral crowd last time, a govern crowd. This had a bit more of a WrestleZone-y vibe with like the KFC chants and what like. So it was a bit more of a tamer crowd, I felt anyway. The match itself, I'll do a proper kind of breakdown thing in tomorrow when I'm at home and I can kind of calibrate my thoughts a bit more and look through the card and see what I can see. But I had a good time. I got coerced into buying a raffle ticket by Rocky Ross. I didn't win the raffle, so therefore I think if because I've been coerced, I don't think that counts as me buying a raffle ticket. Therefore, I'm still undefeated in the raffle. I'm still one and done. Actually, no, I did W3L one last year. I lost that as well. So my losing streak at raffles continues. But WrestleZone one, it stays. It sticks. I'm still undefeated in the WrestleZone raffle because I haven't bought a ticket since I won. That was Halloween Hijinks 2022. But no, it was a fun night. There was plenty of good things I saw. I'm always enjoy seeing Ellie Armstrong wrestle. I think she's just got that kind of factor, I think, in my personal opinion. What I also saw was, oh god, have I gone the right way this time? Ah! Apologies about that. Roundabouts, they do that sort of thing. So hopefully, if I say an Asda, then I have gone the right way. If I don't, I have gone the wrong way. I see the Asda. We're going home the right way. I'm not ending up in Fraserburgh tonight. Woo! So anyway, yeah. So Tracy Armstrong and Nicole Jasmine they put on a very solid match. Brian Mojo, though, I would say is probably the standout. You know, the guy's 16. The kid's 16, and he had a really good match with Renegade Rex in the pre-show and the VIP section. It didn't get a lot of reaction in the crowd, but I think there was only maybe like 15-20 people in the VIP portion of the event, so there was some smattering of cheers and boos. Probably not, definitely not as much as you would see later on, but there was big changes to the card. We didn't get SBS wasn't there. We didn't get Cassie Cook wrestling, and some of the matches were kind of changed about a little bit because it was supposed to be Darrow versus SBX, but ended up being a triple threat with the Attitude Pro Wrestling title on the line, with the Wanderer defending against Mankey Frankie and Darrow. But I will say, I've been critical of Mankey Frankie, saying that he is not Mankey enough. He gave me a bit, when you see him wrestle live, there's a bit more mankiness to him, like kind of going up to the bar and having beers while he's wrestling. Cool. I think he needs to do more. I need more mankiness from Frankie. I need some pacey, you know? I need some blowing snot rags. I need mankiness, you know? I need just being a manky prick. That's what I want. So Frankie, if you want to take anything away from Dave Meltzer here, who doesn't rate matches. I don't rate matches. I talk about matches. I talk about things I like in matches. I don't rate matches. But if you want to take anything away from me, it's be mankier. Come out in bloody flannel. Just be manky, you know? I think there's so much potential in Manky Frankie as a character. And he's pretty, pretty good hand in the ring. There was nothing bad about him wrestling. He was muscling about Darrow like no bother. A lot of that match, that triple threat, like I said, I'll do the proper order when I get the results in front of me, and I can just kind of go through them as I go when I get back into the studio. But yeah, a lot of it was the Wanderer coercing Manky Frankie into doing his bidding, and then eventually Frankie hit the Manky Bomb, and the Wanderer slipped in and got the win and retained his title. But the main event turned into a street fight as expected. I thought one of the matches was going to turn into a street fight. I think I was fairly certain it was going to be this one, where they end up wrestling onto the pitch. I got lots of video you may see in the montage. There was plenty of up close and personal wrestling going up in my grill. I didn't need to zoom in because it was right up close to me. It was just chaos, absolute chaos. And like I say, I think I don't know a lot, but I'm fairly certain wrestling on a football pitch is a dream for many, but possibly something that will get them banned from wrestling in that venue in the future. So it remains to be seen. What else was on the show? So apologies, I'm going to forget stuff, but we'll get back to it. Big Ross and Mayhem Brooks, that was a fun little opener. There was a couple missteps here and there, but we got to see the Mayhem took an absolute killer choke slam. Hopefully, I think I got a video of it, but someone like walked right in front of it, like, just as it was happening. So if I haven't cropped it, I apologise to that person that's going to walk right in front and see just their face appears. So obviously, I'll try and crop it, but I don't edit very well. I'll see how we get from that. That was good fun. Big Ross just again throwing Mayhem about, Mayhem throwing some kicks in. Fun is gonna be my buzzword, it seems, for the second half of the podcast itself. What else did we have? So we had the main event, talked about that. Big Strong Man versus Brian Mojo. Mentioned Mojo being like my MVP of this particular show. He was just full of energy. He put on some really, really solid stuff. He missed it, but including a split leg moonsault, which was nice. I got a clip of that, so again, hopefully it's in the montage and you can see it. But no, he's outstanding. At 16, he has definitely got the potential to do something really special. He's got plenty of time to develop and whatnot. Raven Davey versus Thorin. We've got Raven Davey versus Thorin, and that led into the main event eventually, because Thorin came in to interfere, and then eight Peterhead street fight was called by Davey. So we've got the Govan team and the Vicious Lads against Thatcher Wright, King Nicholas, Justice, Ryan Richards and Thorin. But their singles match again was pretty good. There was no bad matches. They were just like pretty solid matches generally. Like a couple mistakes here and there. Like, but nobody cared. You know, like kids don't care about mistakes. They only care if it's so noticeable. You know, there's ways to get around mistakes, and kids just wanted to shout and chant and watch some wrestling and apparently get into TikTok, because Davey was, I think he was live streaming his entrance on TikTok or videoing his entrance on TikTok, and the kids were just buzzing that they were going to be TikTok famous, you know. So they had that going on. So there was plenty positives. Negatives, it was a bit chaotic. Like, not just the main event, but the raffle was a bit of a chaos after the show. Like, a lot of places, as far as I'm aware, raffle either is after the interval or before the main event, and I think that's your sweet spot for a raffle. If you do a whole show and then you do the raffle, and I get why they do it that way at Community Pro, especially in this show, because at the end you want to get your prize from Ravy Davey, you want to get your prize from the big face team, and they're usually going to be in the main event in the big brawl at the end. So I see why they do it after, but the sweet spot of a raffle, in my experience, is before the main event. You know, everyone's got their raffle prizes, they're hyped, they're excited, they want to see the main event, you know? As far as I've seen some of the belts and that, I really like the GP Dub belt, and I didn't think I would. I think when I saw it on pictures and that, it looks a bit cluttered, but seeing it up close, you know, it's quite a sweet belt, you know? It's quite a sweet looking belt. I wish I got a bit closer to it, but Thatcherite was keeping that well guarded. Thatcher, last time I saw him Peterhead, he caused a chill. I don't know whether it's because the Conservatives are out of power. Somehow Thatcherite feels powerless. You know, last time the Tories were in power and it felt like a looming threat came in when Thatcher came in. But I didn't get that this time, maybe because, like I said, the Tories' power is gone. So therefore Thatcher isn't reminding us of the terror of our nation's government. Perhaps, I don't know. I'm just rambling bollocks now for just to not fill time, but just kind of let my thoughts get out so I don't go home and wake up Kelly and go, look, I've got all these thoughts about this show. Please let me tell you all of them. As far as the crowd, they're doing a little bit of getting into the show. I think it's because it's an L-shaped venue. So the ring's on the corner of the L. So the far side that I was at, I was on like the tip of the L, the lengthways where the entrance was. They got a little bit more like into the entrances. I got to see who's coming out in that. And then when they came round to our side, there was not as many people, and so the sound was a bit more subdued. But plenty of high fives. I was in a high five mood. Clearly, I was getting all the high fives tonight. I was just like, why not? Nobody else is getting one. Throw my hand out, get a high five. And then that's when Monkey Frankie just shouted, oh, it's Dave Meltzer. And I hope it's in good fun. I would hate to think that I go to a show and it's not in good fun, you know, because I'm just a guy that has a blog, that has a podcast, who has no real power in wrestling. If anyone takes my criticism to heart, then don't, you know. I've just watched enough wrestling to maybe form an opinion. But like I say, I don't rate matches. I tell you what I liked about them, and maybe I will give a little bit of if I didn't feel this was right, maybe this could have happened. You know, that's kind of my style. It's nice hindsight. It's armchair booking, armchair criticism. But yeah, like I said, I'll take it in good fun, but please don't take anything I say critical wise to heart. Take all the positives, you know, take all the positives, absolutely boost your ego. I'm not going to stop you. But yeah, it's happened a couple times, so I'm not picking on Frankie specifically, because there's a few times that I've had that kind of comment thrown my way, and I don't believe in. I like the whole Jeff Jarrett quote about Dave Meltzer. He writes some stories to sell newspapers, and that's kind of how I feel about it. But you know, he's done it well. Well, 40 years he's been doing it. I kind of judge that. If I was getting £10 a month from folk just to write some stories, I would be buzzing. Which I kind of do for the Patreon, but you know, that's a pound per person. £1.20, I think, including VAT. So if you want to do that, go to patreon.com/scottresnet. So yeah, so it's like I said, I've taken it in all funny games, but it's a couple times people have said it. So if people do continue to say it, cool, I will not be upset. I want to put out there that I am not Billy Meltzer. I'm not Billy Meltzer at all. But you know, if people want to take anything I say to heart or take it seriously, then that is on them. I will not stop. So yeah, right, okay, there's that little rant. Like I said, it does sound like I'm taking it personally. I'm really not. I hope I understand the joke. I'm just really bad at social cues. I am so chuffed I've actually went the right way tonight. I am not going to Fraserburgh. I'm going to Newport Sligo. It's a shithole. But, you know, I'm not going to... If you do live in Newport Sligo... Sorry. I'm joking. I barely lived there. I was there for, like, 2 years, but I worked in Elgin, so I didn't really live in Newport Sligo because I had to travel 2 hours to work. No. Hour and ten. Hour and ten to work, and then hour and ten back. So by the time I got home, it was, like, near 6:30. Or closer to 7. I was doing nothing except play my PS3 and download stuff off LimeWire. So yeah, show my age there. But no, I had a fun time. Like I say, I don't know if Community Pro will be coming back to Peterhead Football Club. They might. Who knows? They could do. Wrestling's a weird way where things just seem to happen. But I'm a little bit disappointed we didn't get SBX. You know, I like Sam Barber. I was disappointed because we had the belt there, so I thought, oh, Sam's going to be here. But obviously that's not the case. We had no Handsome Man's Club involvement on the show, which you know, was a bit of a shame. But no, I've got to see some folks that I really like seeing, like, say, like Alexi and Ellie. And Alexi, Ryan Richards, I think, is another guy who I think we all know. I think he's got something special. I'm still not convinced by the boxing style shorts, but I think that's more a me thing. That's not anything else. That's not taken away from how good of a confident of a wrestler he is. It's just a style that I don't like particularly. It takes. I can't think of anyone that's pulled it off. So Ryan's doing better than some because he's kind of pulled them off, but I don't like them. But I don't think I'm supposed to like them. I got rid of his gloves. I just realised he hasn't got his gloves. Did he have his gloves tonight? I don't think he did. I'll go check the footage. That is not an important point. This is the rambling stage. This is a proper rambling stage now, where I'm just going, just thinking of things on top of my head. Poor Ryan. During the whole brawl thing. Because there's a lot of the crowd are kids or special needs. You know, special needs is not how it's used now, but I cannot think service users. I don't know. I'm afraid that I've just maybe went into a territory where I'm saying the wrong thing. Those with additional needs. Anyway, those are, yeah, anyway, I'm digging a hole that I don't need to dig myself into. But so he was getting chopped in that by Xander. He was getting chopped by kids, and when everything kind of died down a little bit in the pit, a kid just absolutely leathered him in the back. It sounded so. You can see his face going, "What the f happened?" Kind of this kid just leathered him in the back with a big open hand chop. So I felt a little bit bad for Ryan Richards in that moment. I forgot to ask him. I forgot to see if I saw him briefly as I was leaving. I should have asked him about his wee trading cards thing because I really want one. My trading card game is not going very well. I got a Martin McAllister one through thanks to AR Creations. They've got some cool giveaways, so I'm be entering all of them because I want more. And I was speaking to Ellie, and Ellie had a trading card from TNT, but it was a very limited edition. So if anyone has the TNT trading cards, please let me know. I didn't even know these were a thing, so I really want to know more and hopefully get some. Bloody beeping. At least my brakes aren't making a noise this time. That's better than the last time I did a road trip. Turns out that my brakes were fucked, so I needed to get my brakes fixed, and that was a very expensive day. So I got an Ellie Armstrong sticker. You know, I have not on the other side of the road. Shut up. And yeah, so I got that. That'll appease me for now. But I hope that she kind of does the same thing as Martin. I kind of briefly said to her, and I don't know if it will happen. But AR Creations, you get on this. We've got the lightning. Positivity charge positivity. I will remember this nickname by the time that I do the second portion, the third portion, when I'm in the studio, probably. That Ellie should have the same, but it's the grass type. Get her some grass type energy cards. Get her to sign them. You are sitting on money here, you know. And because I have put this idea out into the ether, I want one. And if I remember, which I will not, And if CPW come back to Peterhead, I will take, I will try to remember to take a grass energy card, and I will get Ellie to sign it myself if I have to, because that is just money sitting on the table, you know. I can't think of it. Try to think of other ones you could do, but my Pokemon knowledge is very much nothing past the first 250, maybe a little bit Gen 3. It could be a dark type. Oh, there's plenty. It could be a dark type. Fairy type. Rock type. Water type. It could be a water type. Anyway, psychic type. I've got into a little bit of... That's my thought for the rest of the evening. I'm going to be looking up the energy card types and assigning them to a wrestler in the hopes that they all steal AR Creations and Martin McAllister's idea and sell Pokemon cards that they've signed. Why not? You know? Sorry, Martin, if I'm taking money out of your pocket. And sorry, AR Creations, if I'm doing the same with stealing Thunder. Thunder type! Oh, no, that's Martin. I'm already there. Where was I? I just passed Minlow. So, if you're still listening to this somehow, it's a name rambling. I eventually will be back in the studio for another bit, because I'll go through each match a little bit. I'll probably have a write up. I'll try to do it in the week following the show. Might be difficult because I've actually got that week off, so I don't know if I'll have time. I tried finding the evening to just knuckle down and type. But no, I had a fun time. I enjoyed the show. I had a good time. There was some silliness. There was some good stuff, and yeah, the crowd enjoyed it. The crowd had a good time. I even cheered and booed just to try and create a little bit of atmosphere in the earlier matches. But when everyone was piling into the stands to watch the wrestling on the pitch, I was just sitting there like my grown-up brain going, oh no, I don't think this is a good idea, but I will still record some clips because I got a montage to make. What else can I say before I go and finish off driving, because I'm about to hit New Pensligo, and I think that's probably a good time to just hit pause and stop and then go try and find an Asda or that to grab a juice for the rest of the journey home. This will be a lot shorter than the journey in. I think I said it in a little bit before, like the second sit down bit in the car, like the 1 minute bit where I did get lost, and I think I was speaking to Callum, and Callum was telling me I could just went to Old Belgium across, but I don't know that road. I know the road to, I know the coast road to Peterhead, and that was the road I was going on. So I could have not have to do that 20 mile detour, but here we are. This is just what happened. Anyway, podcast stuff. Hopefully I'll have some cool news soon. The next road trip will be W3L, and I say that very loosely because that's in Elgin, so I don't know how I'm going to buffer out 20 minutes out of that. We'll see what matches are announced. I'm excited to see Buffa. I've seen Buffa in photo and video form. I've spoken to Buffa on the podcast. I want to see Buffa wrestle. I don't know if I'm about to put that into the ether and he's going to cancel, but I want to see Buffa wrestle. I don't care who he's against. I would love it to be Luke Sharp, because I think that just to tick off that, I think that would be a riot over the W3L title. But yeah, give me Buffa, give me Luke Sharp, and I'm excited to see what we get coming out of that. And then after that, it's Battle of the Nations, which possibly, maybe, perhaps will be Jack's first wrestling event ever. So that may be a very interesting road trip, because that's like a month away, and that a lot happens in a kid's life in that month. I mean, from 1 week to another, he just started pointing his bed and going, bed. You know, that's a very recent thing. And it was incredible, and I found the little things so special and so fun. Especially when he's like, you know, he passes me his bottle and he gives me a hug, pats me on the back, and then goes to bed. You know, like how cool is that? You know, I think it took me years to learn to do that. But anyway, so that could be quite an emotional episode. After that, I don't know. I'm hoping to go to Inverurie, but I'm in Berwick that week, like on a family holiday, and I return on the Friday. So I don't know if I will be mentally prepared for Inverurie on the Saturday, but we'll see what's what. Possibly Fair Say Wrestling September. I was just going to take them show by show and see what we can do, and then probably Christmas Chaos in December. So I'll be missing Halloween hijinks because we're going to see Les Mis in the PNG. So, you know, unfortunately I'm missing Halloween hijinks for the second year in a row, but this time it's not because of fireworks. Don't start with me, Aspen. There was definitely fireworks taking place on that night. So this time I'm missing it because of going to see Michael Ball and Alfie Bo sing Les Mis. So, you know, that's just what happened. Taking that off the bucket list. Anyway, yes, Newport Sligo, turn off to Strachan. I'm not going to Strachan. I'm going through Newport Sligo. Or CAC, as it's called, old schooly called. It says CYAAK. I think I said that fact before in previous episode, but it was a while ago. And it's getting right, foggy. I don't know if it's because you don't want me to see Piss Lego, which is fine. Actually, no, that's a lie. I don't mind it. It's apparently got I don't know if it's still the case, but it's got the longest main street in Scotland, I think. That was a fact that came across like maybe 15 years ago. I don't know if that's still the case or even still a thing, but it's a pretty long street. I'm on it now, so I definitely need to go because it's been 25 minutes of absolute nonsense. Anyway, so yeah, back into the studio in a moment. Hope you enjoyed the montage. Hopefully I haven't reused the same music from a previous montage. If I have, hopefully it's from one of the first couple, so I'm not reusing one after the other. If not, I apologise. If it's one I used like two road trips ago. But in the meantime, back to you, Billy, in the studio. What are you doing?
Hello, I'm back in the studio here. It's not going to be a long bit. This bit. I don't know why I keep doing the thing at the end of the drive home, going back to the studio, because I kind of said pretty much everything I was going to say in that to half an hour of rambling about all things the show. But I've had a day or two to think about it. I'm recording this Sunday morning, the 14th, which has been a very chaotic morning already, just with the, you know, worldwide news. But yeah, thought I'd just go through the full results, because if you haven't went on to swnscotland.com to check out the full results, I don't know why you haven't, but this is 10 days after the fact. When this episode goes out, I think it's going to be 22nd of July. So I'll let you know who won what. Is it 22nd of July? I think it's going to be maybe later than that. I don't know. You'll see it when it comes out. That's the overarching story there. So the VIP bonus match with Brian Mojo defeat the Renegade Rex by pinfall. He said, I really liked what Brian did. Renegade Rex, he provided a really good foil, quite a solid base, and he got a little bit of heat as well, but it was quite a tame audience, I think, for a CPW show, certainly. And there was maybe 20 VIP seats filled, so it wasn't a particularly loud crowd, but I enjoyed what I saw for Brian Mojo, and Renegade Rex certainly held up his end of the bargain as well. On to the main show with Big Ross Hauser versus Mayhem Brooks. Mayhem was the bad guy, not the Conor McGregor ripoff kind of bad guy. He's kind of toned it, but he's still got that kind of cocky swagger about him. It's certainly evolving. It's looking great. And Big Ross was Big Ross. Everyone loved Big Ross coming out with the shades and the big leather jacket, the old Terminator style. And the match itself was some little bits and pieces here that if you're going to be particular about and fussy about, then it probably wasn't the best from either, but in general, really good. You got to showcase Big Ross's strengths, which was the strength. He was able to power it out. There was a great counter, which you'll see in the montage, And when Mayhem was getting choke slammed, he countered it into a triangle choke, and then Ross was able to pick him back up for a power bomb, which looked really cool. And the choke slam at the end, I don't know how Mayhem was able to walk. You shush yourself, laptop. It looked like he landed hard at the top of his back, shoulder, neck area. So he was walking about absolute chipper afterwards. So like after the show, so it didn't do him any lasting damage. It just looked really nasty and really good, I suppose, if it didn't actually have any lasting damage on him. Ellie Armstrong versus Nicole Jasmine. Nicole Jasmine lost by submission to Ellie. Another fun match. There was some slow motion bits, it felt like. Some of the match seemed to be like wrestling in treacle, custard, whatever you want to call it. In moments, and there was a couple little bits here and there. Spare moment.
A few moments later.
Bloody hay fever. I will maybe put something there. Anyway, yeah, Ellie Armstrong, Nicole Jasmine. They had some kind of stuttery moments in the match itself. The finish came out of nowhere as well with the crossface, which was a really nice little setup as well for the crossface from Ellie Armstrong. And I enjoy Ellie Armstrong. I think Nicole had a pretty solid match. Like I say, there's some miscommunication, it felt like, at times, but in general, I had a good time. And Ravy Davey took on Thorin in the first half main event. This just everyone was buzzing to see Ravy Davey. Of course they are, TikTok star, you know, viral mega star with these ratings and food ratings and what have you. So this is another pretty good match. Thorin was I use a lot of as, I'm so sorry. Again, hay fever, kicking my ass in my throat. Mainly my throat. Thorin was kind of on the offensive quite a bit in this. David Davey got in his big moves, got the line salt. Just playing going on. Renegade Rex tried to interfere in the build up to the finish, and then when that kind of went all awry, Thorin ended up hitting Rex with an enziguri, I think it was, and Davey rolled him up for the pin and the win. So that was the first half main event. Was Ravy Davey picking up the win. So it means everyone could be happy and everyone could get in the ring and get their photos done with the CPW belt. There's no SBX in the show, though, so no actual CPW champion on the show. We had the tag team champions, Bross and Darrow, but they were both in singles competition. So the only title on the line was the Attitude Pro Wrestling Scottish Championship, Heavyweight Championship. I think it's just called Scottish Championship, Triple Threat, which I'll speak about in a sec. After the first half made, Renegade Rex tried to attack Ravy Davey and was hit with two RKOs by Davey instead. So again, everyone was hyped. Get their £5 in, get a picture with the belt. Into the second half, this is really low energy. Again, apologising for the throat. Brian Mojo defeated the Big Strong Man. We got Big Strong Man is chaos in himself when he mocked someone for being ginger, which was incredible. Incredible, delusion, I suppose, for the Big Strong Man. I really liked it. And it was just funny. Brian Mojo again, second match of the night, still had a lot of energy. I mean, 16, I don't think I had that much energy at 16. I definitely don't have it at 34. But he had another really great showing. Again, there's a couple bits here and there that maybe could be tighter, but that's just very critical thinking. If I'm watching it as a fan, I enjoy myself because Brian Mojo is really athletic. He's got a good look. He's just going to get better, I think, if he's nurtured and taught by a lot of different heads. I think he's going to have a really good time in the near future. And the Big Strong Man, like I say, chaos into himself. This is supposed to be a pre-show match. I'm glad they moved it into the main card because Big Strong Man thrives off a big, strong reaction, whether it's for or against him. So I'm glad that was moved on to the main show. Very strange to see Brian Mojo out twice, but certainly appreciate because he was one of the highlights of the show. The pre-main event-ish, I'll explain why. There was the APW Scottish Championship in a triple threat. The Wanderer defeated Maggie, Frankie and Darrow to retain the title. This was mainly the Wanderer kind of making Maggie, Frankie do his bidding. And like I said in the drive home portion, I want to see Maggie, Frankie, Mankier. You know, he came out with a half pint of beer. He got another pint drawn for him, and he had that during the match, you know. But I think there's just so much potential for mankiness from Manky Frankie. Darrow was throwing himself all over the place, and quite a few things didn't really go maybe to plan. It was a bit of a messy triple threat, to be perfectly honest with you. It was the Wanderer, like I say, making Frankie do his bidding, but then when Darrow started getting fired up, everything kind of got a little bit loose, like maybe too loose at times, when it came to actually like running moves. But again, this is all from a critical point of watching enough wrestling to maybe see when things possibly don't go right, because again, the crowd were loving Darrow. They were big fans of Darrow. They were shouting for him, and they were really enjoying what he was put on. Eventually, Manky Frankie hit the Manky Bomb, which looked ace. I can't remember what it's called. There's a name for it, and I apologize, I can't remember. It's in the montage. And then just as Frankie looked like he was going to pick up the win, Wanderer threw him out, got the win. Classic triple threat ending from that one. And in the main event, it started as Cousin Xander and the VLs, E-Town and Rocky Ross, against Thatcher Wright, King Nicholas Justice, and Ryan Richards. And it started off as like a kind of chill triple threat, a little bit of shenanigans from Xander and the VLs. Xander got his very own Hawaiian shirt to join in with the VLs. And, you know, it was fun. It was fine. There was things happening. The E-Town or Rocky Ross was cornered for the majority of the match. Stuff happened, you know, got a little bit of double teaming, all that kind of stuff. King Nicholas Justice, I saw the promo photos of him in the SWAT gear. Kind of wish I saw that, but, you know, a crown and a scepter at the belt. It's fun. It's a silly gimmick, but it makes people react. Then during the match, Thorin ran out and attacked Xander. Big chaos, and then Ravy Davey came out to announce that he wasn't going to finish the show that way. Peterhead street fight. Everything went wrong. Well, not wrong, but everything just went just everywhere in the building. Just you see from the montage, just like trying to pay attention to something happening. Thankfully, they all congregated right next to me. And then they went out into the stadium, went into the actual stadium onto the pitch itself. And like I said, I don't know if that's possibly going to be frowned upon from Peterhead Football Club, whether they're going to be coming back again to that venue, but that remains to be seen. But yeah, it was just absolute chaos. We've got the finishers one after the other at the end, and it ended with Ravy Davey hitting the Styles Clash and E-Town hitting Thorin with a Canadian Destroyer as well to round off the match and round off the show as well. So yeah, it was just a fun night. Bit of chaos, a bit ramshackle at points as well, with some things like just looking a little bit messy, but I had a good time, and I think that's the most important thing. I'm not going to do 5-star ratings or anything like that, because I'm not Dave Meltzer, but I had a good time. I'll do a write-up, possibly before this episode. I should have a write-up before this episode goes out, but at least listening to this or watching this, you get to see what my pre- and post-show thoughts are, and you get to see the montage, you get to see some clips from the show as well. But yeah, I'm not going to hang about any longer than I need to, because you've already suffered through an hour of me rambling. I'm just going to move ahead. So the next one will be Wrestling Showdown. No, it won't be. Summer Spectacular. W3L is the next show that I'm going to, which will be the next road trip. The next episode that will be coming out, I think, will be Tim Strange. I don't know. I will go to Twitter, at Scott Resnett, or X, at Scott Resnett. I'll keep you up to date there, or Instagram at Scott Resnett as well. I'll keep you up to date with all the episodes coming out and what's coming up as well on the SWN podcast. But in the meantime, thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. If you want to listen to any of these episodes early, go to patreon.com/ScottResnett. You can do £1 plus VAT. So I think that's £1.20, and you get access to all episodes early, archive content, and some announcements as well for guests that you'll get first most of the time. If I'm getting a guest like the same day, then sometimes it falls through the cracks. But generally, you will get our full lineup of guests, and you'll get the episodes early as soon as possible as well. So thank you for listening. Thank you for watching. Hope you have a good time. Behave yourself. Stay hydrated, etc., etc. And check out our sponsors below, Manscaped, Hot Tag Foundation, and Render Bomb as well. So go check them out. There's some good stuff going on. I'm going to go get on the rest of my Sunday. Have a good one.